In this brief video, I'm going to give an overview of John Searle's Chinese Room argument. If you're already familiar with the argument, then you might want to just skip to a longer video I made called Brains, Machines, and Intentionality, where I get into some topics related to Searle's Chinese Room argument and criticisms of it. However, if you'd like a refresher, or you just don't know what the Chinese Room argument is all about, then this video is for you. So one way of understanding John Searle's Chinese Room argument is that it's an argument against the possibility of artificial intelligence. It's arguing that you cannot make an artificial system, you cannot make a machine that would have genuine intelligence. At best, all you're going to get is a simulation. You're going to get something that goes through the motions but doesn't actually have genuine intelligence. This argument can also be viewed as not only an argument against artificial intelligence, but you could also view it as an argument against the closely related view of functionalism. Functionalism is basically the idea that mental states are definable in terms of causal relations between mental states and also sensory inputs and behavioral outputs. So these kinds of causal relations are what defines mental states. And what doesn't define mental states is anything that would be specific to brains. So a functionalist allows for the multiple realizability of mental states as long as something has the same general coarse-grained causal profile, it can have genuine intelligence. So that's functionalism, and it sounds a lot like artificial intelligence, at least the thesis known as strong artificial intelligence, that says that there can be a machine that, even though it's artificial, can have genuine intelligence. So how does John Searle's Chinese Room argument work? At the heart of the Chinese Room argument is a thought experiment. In this thought experiment, John Searle invites you to imagine that someone comes out with a computer program that is supposed to allow a computer running the program to conduct a conversation with somebody in some dialect of one of the Chinese languages. Instead of imagining that this computer program is going to converse in Chinese with somebody by running a robot that has a mouth and is able to produce audible speech, imagine instead this computer program is interfacing with its interlocutors via written or printed text. So this might be thought of as a program that would be a kind of a chat bot. It's something that you could ask questions to by typing, and it could reply by printing answers on a screen or printing them out on a piece of paper. Imagine computer scientists develop a program that is so sophisticated that it passes a Turing test. People interacting with the program by some kind of textual interface wouldn't know that it was a program. They might be fooled into thinking that they're conversing with a genuine human who understands Chinese. So imagine a chatbot that's really sophisticated enough to pass a Turing test for Chinese understanding. Now, Searle says, here's the thought experiment part. Imagine that program is, instead of typed into a computer to make a computer run the program, that program is instead written out in English, and the program is followed by John Searle, an actual human being, not a machine. John Searle works with the program that is written out in a book. And the way in which he runs the program or follows the program is by being inside of this room. This is the Chinese room. And messages in Chinese are sent into the room through an in slot. And John Searle, who we are hypothesizing or stipulating, doesn't understand Chinese, he only understands English. He receives these Chinese messages and he doesn't understand them. He looks at them and looks in his book. The book has pictures of different Chinese symbols and instructions written in English telling him what Chinese symbols to send out of the room in response to the Chinese symbols that come into the room. Someone on the outside of the room might think that they're having a conversation with somebody that understands Chinese. But really what they're doing, according to John Searle, is they're just interacting with a system that doesn't understand Chinese. In a sense, they're interacting with John Searle, and he doesn't understand Chinese. All he understands is English, and he's following the instructions written in English. In following these instructions, he is running a program that is supposed to be a Chinese understanding program. If this thought experiment is coherent, what we have here is the program being run without anything or anyone thereby understanding Chinese. And according to Searle, this defeats the position of artificial intelligence, or the position known as strong artificial intelligence. This says there could be a machine that has genuine intelligence instead of just weak artificial intelligence, which says that at best you're going to get a simulation, something that goes through the motions without having genuine intelligence. So the argument goes against strong intelligence in the following way. According to strong artificial intelligence, anything that runs the program, the Chinese understanding program, will thereby understand Chinese. Running the program suffices for understanding Chinese. A computer that runs the program would understand Chinese. But, says John Searle, he is running the program without himself understanding Chinese. So therefore, it's not true that anything that runs the program would thereby understand Chinese. John Searle is running the program without himself understanding Chinese. In my longer video on this topic, Brains, Machines, and Intentionality, I get into some of the criticisms that have come up about Searle's Chinese room argument. But very briefly, here's one that John Searle himself discusses. It's a response to the Chinese room argument known as the systems reply. According to the systems reply, someone defends artificial intelligence against the Chinese room argument by saying the following. Well, okay, John Searle doesn't understand Chinese. He's paging through the instruction book written in English. He's following instructions. All he understands is English. He doesn't understand Chinese. However, the entire system of which John Searle is just a part, that whole system understands Chinese. The whole system includes not just John Searle, but also the book that has the instructions. And perhaps the system also includes the symbols coming into and leaving the room. So this whole system, the system that has John Searle as a proper part, but also includes the book with the rules in it, and also the symbols that are being manipulated, it's that whole system that understands Chinese. So according to the system's reply, the defender of artificial intelligence says, okay, so what if John Searle doesn't understand Chinese? John Searle, strictly speaking, is not what's running the program. What's running the program is the whole system, and the whole system understands Chinese. So John Searle has a reply to the system's response. He says, okay, forget about the actual room and forget about the book. Imagine that John Searle memorizes all the instructions in the book. And instead of receiving symbols through some slot in the room, the symbols are just shown to him. So someone holds up a message written in Chinese and he looks at it and he thinks through his memory of the instructions of this book that he's memorized, and he's memorized all the pictures that are in the book. He's memorized all the instructions written out in English about what sort of response to give to certain Chinese inputs. And he thinks through and he realizes that given this one particular Chinese symbol, which he matches to a picture in his memory, he should respond with another Chinese symbol. And he produces the Chinese symbol by just drawing it on a piece of paper. So now what John Searle has done is he's internalized the system. He is no longer a proper part of a system that includes a book and the rest of the things in the room. But the system is something that is inside of him now because he's memorized all the instructions in the book. And you're just showing him symbols and then he's writing or drawing on a piece of paper. And even though he doesn't understand the symbols, he's producing the correct symbols in response to the symbols that are shown to him. So Searle says, once again, we have the program being run without anything or anyone thereby understanding Chinese. The defender of artificial intelligence can't say that Searle now is just a part of the system, because he is the whole system. He is the entire system. He is the thing that results in the right symbol responses to various symbols that are shown to him, but he doesn't understand Chinese. Anyway, that's the gist of Searle's Chinese room argument. If you'd like to hear more, including some criticisms I have of the argument, please check out my video, Brains, Machines, and Intentionality. So what do you think? Do you think the Chinese room argument is a good argument against artificial intelligence? Share your thoughts in the comments. And if you haven't already, please subscribe.